I still try to accomplish these three in this video, and then I have another one or two saved for you in the last part. So when we're combining trig functions with inverse trig functions, the key thing is to work it step by step. And I am well aware that you could just do these in your calculator, well, for the most part. So let's just try to understand what we're up against here. So this first one, we want the sine of the inverse tangent of 1. So I need to worry about the inverse tangent of 1 first. I know that that is 45 degrees. So that means we are just trying to find the sine of 45 degrees, which we know is root 2 over 2. And there we go. We have accomplished the first one. Okay. Cosine inverse of tangent of pi over 4. And again, inside out, right? Worry about the tangent of pi over 4 first. We know the tangent of pi over 4 is 1. And what angle, when you take the cosine of it, gives you 1? 0. So there's the first two. Now, here is a more challenging one. We want the cosine of the inverse sine of 3/5. Now, that might be a familiar ratio to us, but it's not a familiar angle to us. So I can't just work it out from the inside out. But what I can do, I'm going to highlight it anyway. I'm going to say that theta is the sine inverse of 3/5, which means the sine of theta is 3/5. So whatever theta is, that's what I know about it. And what I want to find cosine of theta. Because if I'm replacing all of this with theta, I want cosine of theta. Realize that this is actually a more complicated version of a problem we've solved in the past. If I know that sine of theta is 3/5, well, that means that the opposite side is 3, then the hypotenuse is 5, which means the adjacent side is 4. Okay? So that means cosine of theta, if that's my angle theta, is 4/5. And that is all we really have to say about that. If you want to check it on the calculator, you can. It's going to pull up my calculator here. So I'm just going to do cosine of sine inverse of 3/5. Close the parentheses. And notice we get 0.8, which is 4/5. Might not be as lucky in getting those exact values, though, if we have, say, radicals in them. So that's why we need to understand how to do this without a calculator. So next time you come back, we're going to look at another example here. You can actually see it taunting us from the bottom left-hand corner of the screen. We're going to see how to handle a sum of angles. Okay, so be sure to stay tuned. Thanks for watching.